This video is going to be a short recap of the whole topic. So, vasculitis is vessel wall inflammation. It results in general symptoms due to inflammation and specific symptoms due to downward ischemia. Because of thrombosis, vessel injury and repair, leading to decreasing diameter of the wall, leading to pain and infarction, and general symptoms that are due to inflammation and tissue damage. The classification bases are many. They can be due to vessel size, site, lesion histology, clinical manifestations, pathogenesis, and etiology, but the one we are going to follow here is going to be on the basis of vessel size. The etiology, based on the etiology, we have infectious and non-infectious causes. Infectious causes are aspergillus and mucor most commonly, leading to septic emboli, mycotic aneurysms, and thrombosis. Non-infectious causes can be immune-mediated, which are most common, and due to injury. The pathogenesis due to infectious and injurious causes will be inflammation and repair, and also coagulation that are going to cause fibrosis and thrombosis and thus complications, while the immune-mediated causes are due to immune complex-mediated vasculitis, that is, the immune complex will be deposited and leading to neutrophil and complement activation, leading to endothelial damage. ANCAs mediated, which are anti-neutrophilic cytoplasmic antibodies, which are going to be formed against either the xerophilic granules of the neutrophils or the myeloperoxidase enzyme of the neutrophils, leading to endothelial damage because of proteolytic enzymes and reactive oxygen species that are being released from the neutrophils. And lastly, there can be anti-endothelial cell-mediated antibodies, which are directly against the self-antigens of the endothelial cells. Now, as we said that we're going to classify it on the basis of size, we have small vessel vasculitides. First, we have Wegener's granulomatosis or GPA, granulomatosis with polyangiitis. It will affect upper, lower respiratory tract and kidneys, leading to all of those respective symptoms based on the site. The middle-aged males are most probably affected. The diagnosis are due to can be done by increased serum C ANCAs in 95% of the cases. Remember, C ANCAs for this upper lower respiratory tract and glomerulonephritis. Second, we have microscopic polyangiitis. It doesn't have any granulomas. Remember that. It does not have any nasopharyngeal involvement. Remember that. And it has P ANCAs in place of C ANCAs. Okay. Next, we have Churg Strauss syndrome. It is known as allergic granulomatosis and angiitis. Remember, in this case, three words: allergic, eosinophilia, and asthma. Okay, so it is going to have granulomas, but that is going to be chiefly populated by eosinophils, and mainly it is going to affect lungs and the heart. Remember that. And in this case, we have increased C ANCAs. So we had C ANCAs, then P ANCAs, and now C ANCAs again. Okay. Lastly, we have Henoch Schonlein Purpura, which is not due to ANCAs. It is an IgA immune complex mediated disease. It has palpable purpuras and skin, renal, and joint problems. And chiefly, it is a disease of children. So remember this picture of this child. Next, we have medium vessel vasculitides. The first one is polyarteritis nodosa. Remember this span, and a string of beads, which is the classic appearance on an angiogram. And remember its association with hepatitis B surface antigen, and that lungs are spared. It is going to have two types of lesions, acute and healed lesions, and is going to affect all the organs such as heart, kidney, liver, GIT, skin, and nervous system. Next, we have Kawasaki's disease, also known as mucocutaneous lymph node syndrome, and this name is going to show all of those symptoms. One thing to remember about Kawasaki's disease is that it commonly affects the coronary arteries, leading to MI, and its treatment involves aspirin, and remember the relation with Reye's syndrome. Next, we have the Buerger's disease, which is going to be remembered by eating a burger with cigarette and leading to burning of fingers. So we remember the name by Buerger. Cigarette association due to will be associated with T cell hypersensitivity to smoke modified self antigens, and it is common in heavy cigarette smokers. And the burnt finger will be referring to the auto amputations and the gangrene. It is also going to have two types of lesions, acute and late, and remember the microabscesses in this case. Lastly, we have the large vessel vasculitis, including temporal arteritis and Takayasu arteritis. Now, in between these two, we know that the temporal arteritis is going to be a giant cell. That means it, on histology, it contains multinucleated giant cells, and chiefly the temporal artery or the ophthalmic artery or the aorta are involved. So, it will lead to respective symptoms. Most commonly, females are affected. Okay, and remember this, negative biopsy will not exclude disease because you can pick up the part which is not affected by vasculitis because this disease is focal. Lastly, we have Takayasu arteritis. Remember this, that this is known as pulseless disease, and with that you will remember that this involves the areas classically at aortic branch points, and that is the important points about these. Loss of pulse in upper extremities and the systolic blood pressure difference between the arms. That is all.